independent through Westwood Pentecostal Assembly, just off State Road 23 on the frontage road. Yes, sir. There's a story here about the word of the Lord saving a boy's life in Dayton, Ohio. Ricky Wagner, he's a bus driver up there. It was about 5 o'clock in the morning last week, and he started having some kind of mechanical problem with his bus. So he pulled over and tried to figure out what the trouble was. At that time, two of them gangbanger punks rolled up on him. The police say it was some kind of gang initialization deal where the new guy's got to kill somebody to get in the club. So one of these gangbangers shoots Mr. Wagner 3 times, once in the leg and twice in the chest. But he lived to tell the tale because of what he had in his coat pocket. ABC News called it a religious book. It turns out what he had was something you may have heard of called the Bible. Stopped the 2 bullets from getting to the sweller's heart. Mr. Wagner stuck the boy in the hand with his ink pen and got the gun away from him, and the 3 gangbangers run off somewhere. Now, I don't want to get all Facebooky on you. That right there is a good story. I've been telling you for years, spending time with the Bible can guard your heart against the evils of this old screwed up world. Well, here's something that proves it. Now, don't get me wrong, I ain't saying there's some kind of magic stuff about the book itself. But I'd say if this fella had been reading some of that modern secular trash like 50 Shades of Gay or Harvey Potter and the Gal with the Dragon Tattoo, he might not be alive today. Turns out the Bible the fella was carrying was the one they call The Message, which, if you ain't heard of it, this is one of them so-called contemporary paraphrase versions of the Bible. You know, the kind that takes out all the V's and vowels and uses he and or she and all that gender-neutral, inclusive language, man. Only I don't think much of these newly inspired translations. I mean, if the King James Version was good enough for the Apostle Paul, it's good enough for me. But this here shows the power of the Word. Sometimes even a watered-down, modernistic Presbyterian sounded more like The Message in simple life. Cow-bound unbelievers might not like getting thumped by a Bible, but if you carry one, it could keep you from getting thumped. Run for that. The very best Bible is the one that you carry in your heart. Even if you ain't got one in your pocket, that right there will protect you on both sides of eternity. Come meet the living Word of God, the Lord Jesus Christ, this Sunday morning at 11 o'clock a.m. at the Sword of Joshua Independent Full Gospel Pentecostal Assembly, just off State Road 23 on the frontage road. This is Reverend Billy Ray Collins reminding you it's time to turn so you don't burn. Young boy and Billy, come on. You old keep on straight up fire.
Get out of here.